Hi, today's project is this pretty bow ornament. I'm calling it an ornament because I'm actually putting it on the tree, and I'll show you how I'm going to do that. But you can make this actually into a hair bow also if you'd like. This is being done using our glitter net and laces. This is one of the glitter nets. This is style 8055, and we carry it in either red with glitter or white with glitter. And then we also have some laces and a metallic gold and silver net that we're going to show you how we're going to do it also. This is a piece that's about 16 inches long, and I'm going to take this and I'm going to fold it in half just because I want to know where my middle point is so that I can fold this evenly. So now that I know this is my middle, I'm just going to fold one side over, overlapping that center point about an inch, and fold the other side over, overlapping that center point about an inch. Using my fingers, I'm going to gather this up in the center. This net is stiff. It's got a lot of body to it, so we're going to be able to fan this out afterwards. And then I'm using a wire twisty tie. If you don't have twisty ties in your drawer, get like about a 18 or 20 gauge wire in the floral department to use to be able to twist in the center. But these are those little twisty ties you get when you buy plastic bags at the store or produce and stuff. Just save the little wires. They're great for all these projects. So I twisted this around the middle and then I just snipped off my extra. So here's my base part of the bow. I want to make my center. So I'm going to use the metallic mesh one. This is style number 8054. We carry this in silver or in gold. And I measured a piece about 12 inches long because I want this to be smaller than my other piece. I'm going to do the same thing though. I'm going to fold this in half just so I know where my middle point is so that I can fold this and overlap that middle about an inch again, both directions. And then again, take my fingers and just gather this up in the middle. And using again one of those little twisty tie wires, I'm going to wire this in the middle. And when you do it, just kind of look at it, make sure it looks like you're balanced and it's even. Snip off the extra wire. Okay, so you can see we're going to take this one and put it on top of that one to create a layer. So I'm going to use my low melt glue gun, put some glue in the center of the top one, and glue it right on top of the bottom one. Just hold it together for a minute so that it stays together. Now, I can either take this bow and just fluff it up to give it some body, like this, or I can take the ends and tuck them in so they're a little more rounded. It's a personal preference. If you're doing this as ornaments, you're probably going to do many of them. So you can do some one way and a few a different way. On the little tree here, I have one that has a gold center that's really small. I did it the same way that I did this one here. I just used a piece of net for the middle part that was maybe about 8 inches wide to start with instead of 12 inches wide, so it just made a smaller piece. So I'm going to fluff this out by putting my finger through it. And then we're going to put this onto a clothespin. This is just a basic wooden clothespin. They also make plastic ones. I've got the wooden ones. And I'm going to take this and glue it onto my clothespin so that I can use this to pinch onto my branches of the tree. So I'm just going to put some glue along the top of this. And place it on the back of my bow. Press down the two sides. And, oops, I forgot a step. Let me take this off of here before it dries too much. I need to cover up my wire in the middle here. So I've got a piece of 3/8 inch ribbon. I'm putting a little bit of glue on one end of it. I'm going to glue it to the back. Bring this around the front so it covers up my wire. And then a little piece, bit of glue in the back again. Got a little bit of extra ribbon here. I'm going to cut that off. All right, let's go back to our clothespin. I am right-handed, so I want it to open this way. So I'm making sure I'm going to have it open the correct way. And again, I'm going to put glue on here. Generous amount, because I really want it to hold on to my bow. And press this down on here. Now, when you're pressing this onto your clothespin, make sure you stick your fingers inside the loops of the bow, because if I press this down from the top here, I'm going to glue the top of my bow onto the clothespin also, and I don't want to do that. I want to be able to have this shaped as a pretty bow on the top. And then again, I'm just going to put my fingers between the loop areas to be able to pull this out and give it a little more shape. Now, this is just a basic way to be able to make your bow. If you don't want to use this for an ornament on the tree, you can make this the same way, and instead of gluing it onto your clothespin, glue it onto one of the barrette clips, and you have hair bows to wear every day of the year that will be very pretty. We carry the glitter net, which is style number 8055, in two colors, the white or the red. The metallic knit mesh is number 8054, and we carry that in the gold or the silver. And then we also have a glitter on lace, which comes in the white or the natural. This is the natural color. They all come on 10-yard spools. You can buy them by the yard if you're just needing a small amount. If you're needing a lot to do many projects using it as garland, they come on the 10-yard spools for you. Give us a call. We'll be happy to help you out. The phone number here is 800-368-3186. Thank you.